The last step in our look at size scales is the galactic scale. Here the big idea is simply this. Our Milky Way is a galaxy.
If you get out to a dark location, far away from any city lights, you can see a bright, patchy band cutting across the sky. This is the Milky Way, and what you're seeing is the light of millions of stars.
In the early 20th century, astronomers came to realize that the Milky Way is really a galaxy, a huge disk of stars. We see it as a band because we're inside it. One person who had a lot to do with our understanding of what galaxies are was this man, Edwin Hubble. His work showed that our galaxy is really just one of many galaxies in space.
Our galaxy is about 100,000 light-years across. We live 28,000 light-years from the center, out in the galactic suburbs. The galaxy is 1,000 light-years thick where we are, but it gets 10 times that thick near the center. There are a couple of hundred billion stars in our galaxy. Remember that our Sun is just one mid-sized star in that collection.
When we look up at the night sky, most of what we see is our neighborhood. Stars in a small region right around the Sun's location. Because of all the dust in the plane of the Milky Way, we can't see much beyond a few thousand light-years along the disk of the Milky Way without specialized telescopes. However, when we look outside the plane, we avoid all of that dust. So in addition to neighbor stars, in these directions, we can also see what lies outside of our galaxy. To get a better sense of our galaxy, draw a face-on sketch of the Milky Way, filling most of a standard sheet of paper, about 8.5 by 11 inches. Put on it the Earth, the Sun, the nearest star Proxima Centauri, and one of the largest stars we know of, Eta Carinae. On this scale, some of these will be the same dot. If stars like Eta Carinae are scattered at regular intervals of about 10,000 light-years throughout the disk of the Milky Way, how many of them could you fit on your sketch? One way of doing this is to try drawing circles of about 10,000 light-years in diameter, staying in scale with the rest of your drawing. Assume a star like Eta Carinae is at the center of each of these circles. Approximately how many of these 10,000 light-year circles fit in your sketch? Note that massive stars are almost certainly not so evenly scattered, but making that assumption is a fine starting point for your estimate.
When we look out of the Milky Way, we see that there are almost 100 billion galaxies in our observable universe. In this picture, almost all you see are other galaxies. You can see the shapes of the closer large ones, but even most of the dots on the screen are also galaxies, just farther away. Among the ones you can see clearly, there are disks and balls and spirals and other shapes that are a little harder to describe. In fact, there is a wide range of galaxy shapes.
This next picture is a spiral, sort of like our Milky Way. But there's a smaller galaxy passing it, stretching out one of the spiral arms as it goes. All of those red patches are giant star-forming clouds, like the ones we saw earlier in Carina.
This one is also a spiral, a big one, but we're seeing it edge-on. Its central bulge is huge, and we can see the dust in its disk as a dark band right across the middle of the picture.
This last one is a real oddball, a ring galaxy. It's what happens when two galaxies collide and one goes right through the middle of the other. The ring is almost like a splash flowing out from the center of the collision.
In fact, it's probably best to think of a galaxy as being a fluid. While they seem like they don't move on our timescale, if you wait hundreds of millions of years, galaxies flow like water.
Here's a map of our galactic neighborhood. We're part of a small group of galaxies known as the Local Group. Yeah, it's a very creative name. There are around 30 galaxies in the Local Group, most pretty small.
The other really big galaxy like ours is labeled the Andromeda Galaxy. You can see this one for yourself. If you get somewhere away from city lights in the early fall, you can see a small fuzzy patch of light in the sky towards the constellation Andromeda. This is the Andromeda Galaxy, and it's the farthest thing you can see without a telescope, around 2.5 million light years away. When you see this galaxy, you're seeing light that has been traveling for over 2.5 million years.
Our local group is on the outskirts of a cluster of thousands of galaxies called the Virgo Cluster. We're looking here at the center of this big group of galaxies, over 50 million light years away.
As we look at still larger scales, we find that clusters of galaxies combine into even bigger structures called superclusters.
Here's a map of a large part of the universe. The two wedge shapes are in the directions out of the plane of our Milky Way. Each dot you see here is a galaxy. Notice the scale. We're now looking at a region billions of light years across. At this scale, we see large clumps of galaxies with huge empty voids between them. The outer edges of the map fade out simply because it gets harder to see galaxies this far away, and this particular survey didn't include them. In the early 20th century, astronomers like Hubble noticed something amazing about galaxies. Galaxy clusters are moving away from each other. In other words, the universe is expanding. This discovery now shapes our understanding of the entire universe.
If everything is spreading apart now, then in the past, everything had to be closer together. In fact, the whole universe must have started at a single point almost 14 billion years ago. This is what we call the Big Bang.
Remember that the farther away we look, the farther back in time we're looking. You could ask if we could see all the way back to the Big Bang. We can't do that, but we can get close. About 400,000 years after the Big Bang, the gas of the universe spread out enough to become transparent. The light emitted at that time is still traveling through space today, and we can see it if we use radio telescopes.
Here's a map of this cosmic background radiation, effectively the light of the Big Bang. The bright and dark spots represent dense and sparse regions of gas. These dense spots eventually collapse to form superclusters of galaxies, like the ones we see around us today.
Okay, let's summarize the scales of the universe. We live on a planet, one of 8 planets, and lots of smaller stuff that orbits around our star, the Sun. We call this the solar system.
Our star is one of a couple of 100 billion stars that make up our Milky Way galaxy.
Our galaxy is a member of the local group of galaxies, which is just a small part of the 100 billion galaxies in our observable universe. Here is one more type of exercise for you to do. In these Making Sense Of assignments, we'll ask you to review the material we've covered to fill in a table. This will help you organize many of the important ideas and help you later when you're working on homeworks and studying for exams. Sometimes you can fill in the entire table at once. In other cases, we'll give you a table early on, and then you'll have to add to it as you work through later chapters of the course. These ones will help you see more of the connections and parallels between different parts of the course. On this table, we'd like you to look at the 3 big size scales we've discussed: the solar system, stellar, and galactic scales. In each of these columns, you should list the light travel times to typical objects on these scales. In other words, how many light minutes, light hours, or light years away are these sorts of objects? You should list typical ranges here. In the second column, you should list what sorts of objects we see on each of these scales. Go back through the lecture to remind yourself of what we see in each of these.
Let's finish up with a look at timescales. We just mentioned that the time since the Big Bang, effectively the age of the universe, is almost 14 billion years.
Also, remember that our Sun is not a first-generation star. It formed from the debris of previous stars, so it started more than 9 billion years after the Big Bang, or about 4.6 billion years ago.
Life on our planet started fairly soon after the planet itself formed, certainly by 3.5 billion years ago, but probably even earlier than this.
We can compare this to human timescales. Humans have been on the planet for around 200,000 years, or 0.0002 billion years. Finally, we've had writing for just 6,000 years, or 0.000006 billion years ago. Everyone whose name you've ever heard of lived in just that short period of time.
Okay, here's another your turn assignment. This time, we'd like you to imagine someone saying to you, "A recently launched NASA spacecraft will soon let us see pictures of the Milky Way from outside of the galaxy." Would this sound like a reasonable statement or not?
Notice that we're not asking if such a mission has been launched. It hasn't. Instead, we're asking if it's possible. Think about what it would take to travel outside the galaxy, how fast you would have to go, and how long it would take. In other words, apply what you've just learned about astronomical distance scales.